Finns do have a special relationship to nature. We are nature lovers. Most of us do realize the total dependency our economy and our well-being has on the nature because of the big role of the forests.
If the European Union is a leader in climate change mitigation efforts, Finland is a leader within the European Union. Finland was the first country to implement a carbon tax in 1990, more than 30 years ago.
Finland is extremely ambitious about the climate policies. We aim to become first advanced carbon neutral economy by 2035. It means that we have to reduce our emissions by 64% from today, and it's a huge task.
Our basic approach to climate change, you can say, is that all things made of fossil materials today can be made of renewable materials, specifically wood.
In a country like Finland, the wood is truly renewable.
Wood is super material because it's built out of fibrils which are as strong as carbon fibers. And it's everywhere. The question is just the knowledge to convert it to the, say, added value products.
If you talk about wood-based construction, I think we are on the top of the world. Wood construction helps us to reduce the volume of cement in building, and that has a clear impact.
You can compare it to traditional solid logs. Such logs are very long-lasting and they store carbon.
I think the difference here is that using wood as a material basically reduces the carbon footprint by 20-30%, which is a lot.
So our innovation is the technology that enables producing fabrics and fibers completely with no harmful chemicals. Also, 99% less water is being used compared to, for example, cotton. So this is very disruptive. This is what no one else has done before.
People started to realize that, for example, plastic packaging is really detrimental to the nature.
Today our main products are wood-based packaging materials, cartons and cardboards. They replace fossil-based materials in packaging and logistics. The value chain is very long and it spreads the benefits to the whole of the society.
The example of Finland shows that a small country can make a big difference.